2 weeks ago, she told us about the deaf mute. Last Sunday, the kindness of the Good Samaritan. Today, the touching scene of the ten lepers whom Jews healed. It is in this way that the church tries to awaken in each one of us humble consideration of our mystery and to show us the immense need we continually have of the redemptive work of our Lord in our souls. At the same time, she wants to make us feel that this work is always in action and that we are living under His influence every day and every moment. The passage in the Gospel chosen for today's Mass is especially effective in making clear the chief purpose of our redemption, the healing of our souls from the leprosy of sin. Now, the question Jesus asked in the Gospel when he says, "Were not ten made clean? Where are the other nine?" This question could be applied to any one of us, because somehow or another, sometime in our life, we forget, we have the tendency to forget the most important thing. Especially after we receive blessings and graces from our Lord. And that is simply being grateful for what we receive. And not that we mean to be ungrateful, but we are sometimes so taken up with the cares and troubles of this life, so worried about our present needs, so anxious about our future plans, that we forget for the most part to look back and forget everything that God has given us. And so the little time we devote to pray, usually we spend that time in thanking and asking God for more favors rather than thanking Him for everything He has given to us. And the thing is that we do not receive more of what we need simply because we were not grateful the time before. And so many of our doubts and many of our difficulties and most of the dryness of our souls from which sometimes we suffer come from not being grateful to God. Even when we have a difficulty overcoming certain sin, it is simply because in the past we've never been grateful for God's forgiveness and mercy. So, it would be everything for us today to acknowledge that, you know, if all creatures in this world are grateful to God by becoming or being what they are supposed to be in all their splendor and beauty, we, on our part, being even rational beings, decide being something else, other than bringing out the best version of ourselves, that is, being holy. And that is a kind of ungratefulness. Because with everything that God has given to us, every event in our lives, and even all the people we have come in contact with through our lives have had no other purpose in life than to invite us to become generous and be holy. Now, time and time again, our souls have been healed through the sacrament of penance. And I can tell you that in most of the cases, people prepare well for confession and do good confessions. But it is not very often to see people spending time after confession to thank God for that tremendous gift. In fact, we have the tendency to believe that, you know, confession works as a car wash. And that's all we need to do. So we do our penance, the little penance that the priest sometimes needs. We feel that that's all we need to do. In most of the cases, we don't even have specific, concrete desire to do something about the sins we just confessed, let alone thanking God for the gift of absolution. So, I mean, we could hear our Lord so many times saying, "What about the other man?" So, let us try to be more generous in our thanksgiving to God. For He loves